Please welcome Dr. June Ross Mitchell and Lily, the young subject of the book, Conversations with the Devil.
I really don't think it's a good idea, Jack. It's becoming more unpredictable.
That's a good thing. That's why we still do what? TV.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stay tuned for a live television first as we attempt to commune with the devil.
Lily, can you hear me?
Good to see you again, Jack.
Lily, return to me.
This isn't about ratings anymore.
No one's going anywhere.
How could you let it happen, Jack? How could you let it happen?
Please be warned, anyone with young children in the room. You're about to see.
You okay, Jack?
It's profoundly disturbing and shocking.
Psychologist who
has been studying a woman, a girl who has been possessed, and one of the last members of this cult who committed suicide. She apparently survived somehow. Possibly it was some ritual, ritualistic sacrifice of all the cult members to bring this demon into this girl. Who knows? But, you know, they woke her, Jack Dalton books her to get on the show for readings, along with another psychic and a skeptic, once former magician, now turned paranormal investigator and debunker on the show in his attempt to get the number one time slot away from Johnny Carson and get his show renewed. And that is what takes place in this movie throughout this hour-long variety kind of show slash interview show. We see, you know, first the psychic comes on, and right away he falls ill because he's sensing such a demonic presence with this girl, Lily, who's to come on later in the show. He ends up dying. The skeptic denounces the psychic's earlier performance, not knowing that he dies later in the trip to the hospital after getting violently ill on television. And once the parapsychologist and Lily, the possessed girl, take the stage and basically unleash this demon for the audience to see as the skeptic goes about to attempt to prove and denounce, prove that it's fake and denounce it, believing that is a mass hypnosis type of thing. However, the demon did seem to know only certain things that Jack, the talk show host, would only know. That his wife had died of a strange illness, apparently lung cancer for some reason, although she never smoked a day in her life. Things that the secret cult that he was involved in earlier, in an attempt to gain more professional power in Hollywood, etc. And things go very, very much awry on stage during the live broadcast of this talk show. And essentially that is where we get. Now, I like this. The world building in this is superb. You know, there's plenty of clips from, you know, the 70s, the Carter years, you know, talks about inflation, etc. Of those days, Manson, etc. This fits perfectly into this and the rise of satanic worship, etc. All of the crazes that we're going back on in the 70s. And the set design for this Night Owl show was very good. As a man who grew up in the 70s, as a child watching a lot of late night television, a lot of talk shows, this had the feel of a Donahue, Dick Cavett kind of show. So, you know, props to that. The only flaw with this show is the special effects. Once the demon is fully unleashed from the girl, you know, you get some lightning bolts, some smoke, you know, just general special effects, where they just really didn't have the budget, and it shows that this was basically made for TV kind of movie feel to it. You know, back in the 70s, early 80s, these effects would have been okay, but in, you know, the 21st century, they don't quite work. Unfortunately, they don't focus on those effects too much, but when they do, it is very, very noticeable, unfortunately, and almost laughable, which takes you a little bit out of the show. But, you know, had this been an Amazon, Apple, or Netflix movie, even, the
budget would have been that much more, the special effects would have been that that much better, and thus, you know, this whole demon possession, kind of story would have had much, much more weight. But still, with the water building, the way that they were setting it up, and even with, you know, the acting, everybody was, you know, really felt like, yeah, this is a 70s, you know, the set design, the costumes, you know, the war, you know, I remember it. Etc. And, you know, again, just the feel of an authentic talk show back in the day like that. Remembering the Cabot Show and the Phil Donahue Show, along with, you know, the old Johnny Carson Show, did have that kind of cheapy kind of feel to the sets, which, you know, was very authentic because of the budget. And, you know, this is TV, still the new medium, still fairly new, back from the 50s. Still kind of breaking it in. So it did have that very authentic feel, and this is being kind of told as one of those found footage documentaries. The reel of the filming is basically what we are getting from this show. We are watching it as it unfolded live way back in 1977. Studio audience, and apparently broadcast to the world, that apparently had been forgotten or covered up from police or whoever. And we find out that, you know, that possibly this demon is still somewhere out lurking in the airwaves, having been released live on the show. And, you know, the conclusion is still pretty muddy as far as what exactly happens, but it seems that, you know, everyone on the show ends up pretty much dead, except for the talk show host, who seems that the demon has left alive to take the fall for these murders. Maybe talk show host gone crazy because of his low ratings, stress too much for him, etc. Probably the prosecution would go with, as he went mentally insane on the air and killed all these people. Perhaps, you know, would be the explanation as the cameras cut out here and there, only to come back to, you know, him still around with these dead bodies and him eventually stabbing the girl who had this possessed, thus possibly releasing it, maybe him taking it in to himself. This could very well get a sequel. I mean, this is definitely a low-budget show, but it is interesting. This is the kind of a scary movie, thinking scary movie set up with lots of history and kind of, stuck into the truth slightly, as I like to see, very much more than just your average slasher kind of. I would say this is probably, overall, I enjoyed this more than Immaculate, and probably wouldn't mind seeing this movie again, and like I say, hopefully, possibly a sequel, whereas, you know, the talk show host could still be jailed, maybe he'll go try and hunt this demon if he's ever released from jail, or escapes. Because it's very clear that the demon is still out there somewhere in the ethers of the broadcast airwaves, still causing trouble throughout the world. But again, overall, shot the thumbs up for Late Night with the Devil. Really like how this was presented. It had the skeptic against, psychic, and then parapsychologist just